I'm still grappling with the fact that I'm actually back here on campus. I, again, never intended to come back here, never planned to be back here.
A bittersweet day for Lenny Liggins Willis, one of 89 Ole Miss students arrested 50 years ago. Liggins Willis, in this picture with other African-American students, the night they demonstrated for change at the university, the group became known as the Ole Miss Eight.
Well, I guess to this day, we still don't really know how the eight were singled out. We were told that because they could recognize us in the picture, but we didn't do anything different from the rest of the group.
At the time, the Black Students Union drafted a list of 27 demands for the school's administration. Demands Liggins Willis says fell on deaf ears.
A number of things that we were asking for that did not exist. There were approximately 200 blacks on the campus at that time. And so we felt isolated. We did not have the opportunity to really become a part of the campus and have that campus experience.
50 years later, the Ole Miss Eight gather on campus to share their memories of the night they were arrested, some of them taken to Parchman Prison.
Worried in the backseat of the patrol car whether someone would pull us over in the middle of the night and we'd be a mound somewhere out there.
Liggins Willis admits there have been some positive changes at Ole Miss, but says more needs to be done. While she's had to wait 50 years to receive her diploma,
I was not allowed to graduate to receive my diploma with that 1970 class.
There was some satisfaction in finally hearing a heartfelt apology from the university.
I am sorry that your life was complicated by decisions made by the stewards of the institution at that time. I am sorry that you were forced to leave an institution that was created to give you opportunities.